أن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. الحمد لله. We praise Allah. We seek His assistance and we seek His forgiveness. And we seek refuge in Allah from the evil within ourselves and from our bad deeds. Whoever Allah guides, there is none that can lead him astray. And whoever is led astray, then there is no guide for him. I bear witness that no God has the right to be worshipped other than Allah. He is alone and has no partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad is his slave and his messenger. O you who believe, fear Allah as he ought to be feared, and don't die except as Muslims. O humanity, fear your Lord who has created you from a single soul and created from it its mate and scattered from them too many men and women. And fear Allah for whom you demand your mutual rights, and don't cut off relations with the wombs that bore you. Indeed, Allah is a raqib over you. O you who believe, fear Allah and say that which is correct, in order that He may accept from you your deeds and forgive you of your sins. And whoever obeys Allah and His Messenger has achieved the greatest achievement. Amma ba'du. Certainly the most truthful speech is the book of Allah, and the finest guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the most evil of affairs are newly invented matters in this deen, and every newly invented matter in this deen is a bid'ah, and every bid'ah is a strain, and every strain is in the hellfire. Before we begin with our talk, the da'wah of Islam, the da'wah to Salafiyya, I just wanted to thank my colleague Abu Usama al-Zahabi, hafazahullah, for doing an excellent job on that deviance that has crept into our community, or the deviance that was here before the truth came. It reminds me, and I was talking to him after the lecture, of a statement of Sheikh Mukbil, when he said, I remember when the da'wah of such and such, a false da'wah came to us. I think he referred to the Shiites in one of the examples. He said, I remember when that da'wah came, and I remember when the sunnah crushed it, and I remember the day we made Salatul Janazah on that da'wah. And then he mentioned the next da'wah that came. And then he said, I remember it came, and I remember the sunnah crushed it, and I remember we made Salatul Janazah on that da'wah. I think after this talk of Abu Usama, inshallah ta'ala, I think it's time that, I think that was the janazah, inshallah ta'ala, on that false da'wah, once and for all. It came and the sunnah crushed it, walhamdulillah. I just want to make clear that we don't understand when the janazah was made on the da'wah that we killed the people of that particular da'wah. No, everybody is Muslim, and it's not permissible for the Muslim to kill a Muslim. This is on the issue of the da'wah and their methodology and their teachings. It was false, and it was cleared up, and it's over with. Walhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. And I hope that this talk... Captain, is this person? I hope that this talk, inshallah ta'ala, just makes this da'wah, the da'wah of Islam, a da'wah to Salafiyya, clearer for myself and for the Muslims. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He tells us to begin with His book, إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. Indeed, the deen with Allah is al-Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who named this deen Al-Islam, as he did in this ayah, and as he did in the ayah of Surah Al-Ma'idah, الْيَوْمَ يَأِسَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ دِينِكُمْ فَلَا تَخْشَوْهُمْ وَخْشَوْنَ. اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. This day have the kafirs giving up all despair from turning you back from al-Islam to kufr. So don't fear them, but fear me. Today I have perfected for you your deen and completed my favor to you and have chosen for you Islam as your deen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who named this deen. He's the one who completed it and chose it for us. Alhamdulillah. وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِي غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقَبَلَ مِنْ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. And whoever desires a deen other than al-Islam, it will never be accepted of him in the hereafter, he'll be amongst the losers. This is deen of al-Islam. And today, inshallah ta'ala, we want to take a look at some of the ayat and some of the hadith of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam and some of the statements of the ulama to show what is this al-Islam that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning, as he tells us in Surah Yunus, قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ قَدْ جَاءَكُمُ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ فَمَنِ اهْتَدَى فَإِنَّمَا يَهْتَدِي لِنَفْسِهِ وَمَنْ ضَلَّ فَإِنَّمَا يَضِلُّ عَلَيْهَا وَمَا أَنَا عَلَيْكُمْ بِوَكِيلٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to say, and those believers after him say, O humanity, the truth has come to you from your Lord. So whoever is guided, then he only guides his own soul, and whoever is astray, then he only leads himself astray, and you are not a guardian over them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent his messenger alayhi salatu wa sallam with the truth from his Lord, the book of Allah, the Quran. And this Quran is the truth, and this is where this deen of al-Islam is based on. It's based on the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Quran. Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهِ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, say, he's talking to his messenger alayhi salatu wasalam and the ummah, say, if you love Allah, then follow me. Allah will love you and forgive you of your sins. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in this ayah and other ayahs, as he tells us, وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنُهُ فَانْتَهُوا. Whatever the messenger gives you, take it, and whatever he prohibits you, leave it. This deen is from the book of Allah. And in the book of Allah, we find it points to following the sunnah of the messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this is the way of the believers. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ ولا مؤمن إذا قضى الله ورسوله أمرا أن يكون لهم الخيرة من أمرهم. That it is not proper or befitting for a believing man or a believing woman, once Allah and His Messenger has decided an affair, that they have a choice in that affair. This is this deen of al-Islam. It is the book of Allah, and it's the sunnah of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And every belief we hold and every statement we make and every act of worship whereupon, it must be based on this book, the Quran, and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And then the point of our talk. This Quran and Sunnah is understood on the understanding and the practical application of the Salaf al-Salih, referring to the companions of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa radiallahu anhum. And then their companions, the Tabi'un. And then the Tabi'een, their companions, and then the scholars of Islam, generation after generation, who was following this understanding and practical application of the Quran and the Sunnah. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches us in Surah At-Tawbah, وَالسَّابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنصَارِ وَالَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ وَأَعَدَّ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي تَحْتَهَا الْأَنْهَارُ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا أَبَدًا ذَلِكَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us the first foremost from amongst the muhajirin and the ansar and those that follow them bi ihsan, follow them in the way that they worshiped Allah and the way that they believed in Allah and the way that they propagated this deen, Allah is pleased with them and they are pleased with Him, and He has prepared for them jannat, gardens underneath which rivers flow, abiding there forever, and that is the greatest achievement. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is praising the companions of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam and those that follow them, that Allah is pleased with them and that Allah has prepared for them jannah, to show that this deen this following of the Quran and the Sunnah and this deen of al-Islam is going to be practiced and is going to be understood and implemented in our lives the way that the first generation of Muslims implemented in their lives from amongst the Muhajireen and the Ansar that were with the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this next ayah also makes this point clear as he says, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقَ الرَّسُولِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمْ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. And whoever opposes the messenger after clear guidance has come to him and follows other than a path of the and follows other than the path of the believers, we will turn him to that which he turns himself to and enter him into Jahannam or what an evil abode. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayah when he revealed it to his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the early days of Al-Madinah, the path of the believers was none other than the path of those who were with the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And this is clear from this ayah and is just upon us to think of the example. Is Allah referring when he says, and whoever follows other than the path of the believers, that our path of this sin and this deviance from the Quran and the Sunnah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is referring to the companions of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam, who he said in this ayah previously that he is pleased with them and those who follow them bi ihsan. This is the only way to practice this Quran and this Sunnah in our lives is the way of the people who came before us. This point is a point that no Muslim in his right mind denies. That this deen, al-Islam, is the Quran and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as it was understood and practiced by the companions of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa sallam and everyone who came after them with their same practice and understanding of the Quran and the Sunnah. This point right here, this explanation, this is what is known as the Da'wah As-Salafiyya. And for the people who keep pointing the finger, and the people who keep questioning and wondering why, and what is this Da'wah As-Salafiyya, it is the only true Da'wah of Al-Islam, the Da'wah that you just heard, based on the Quran and the Sunnah, and we want to keep it that short. The da'wah of Islam is the da'wah to Salafiyya, is following the Quran and the Sunnah with the practical application and the understanding of the companions of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa radiallahu anhum and the people who came after them with their understanding and their practical application of the Quran and the Sunnah. This calling of the da'wah a da'wah to Salafiyya is not an innovation and it's not something new. But it was on the tongue of Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the last prophet and messenger to humanity. And we'll take this hadith in its context from Sahih Muslim, where the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa sallam was approaching his death, and his daughter Fatima radiallahu anha began to cry. And the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa sallam, he said to her, Fattaqillah وَاصْبِرِي فَإِنَّهُ نِعْمَ السَّلَفُ أَنَا لَكِ. The Messenger of Allah عليه الصلاة والسلام told Fatima, be patient. Fear Allah and be patient because indeed I am the best salaf for you. I am the best predecessor for you. Here the Messenger of Allah عليه الصلاة والسلام, he's showing his daughter Fatima رضي الله عنها that when I leave, and there's no more revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the way that you must hold on to after me is what I left behind with you from the book of Allah and the sunnah of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is to follow your salaf, the ones who came before you, as the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa sallam gave with this hadith himself as the example. And in the narration of Imam Ad-Darimi, he gave all of the righteous people who follow the Quran and the Sunnah with understanding of the Salaf al-Salih, as he said, يَذْهَبُ الصَّالِحُونَ أَسْرَافًا, that your righteous predecessors have already died off. The Messenger of Allah عليه الصلاة والسلام gave this hadith as advice to this ummah. If you want to be on this Sirat al-Mustaqim, if you want to follow this deen of al-Islam, if you want to be on the correct understanding and application of the Quran and the Sunnah, then follow your righteous predecessors who have died off before you. Righteous predecessors in the Arabic language is called as-salaf as-salih. This language has been around from the tongue of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, the tongue that only the truth comes off of alayhi salatu wasalam. And it's not for the people to doubt anymore. It's not for the people to say we don't understand anymore. It's not for the people to say there's a problem going around America called the Dawah to Salafiyya. This is the Dawah of Islam, and this is the Dawah of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, and the books of Islam, from the collections of hadith and the books of tafsir and the books of fiqh and onward, are flooded with this term, following the Salaf al-Saleh. The only reason that we were unaware of in America maybe is that we didn't know the Arabic language. And because of that, our eyes couldn't read across the books where the statements of a Salaf al-Saleh are flooded in the books. And inshallah ta'ala, Allah is going to bless us to understand this language. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us to understand this language and to read the books of al-Islam as all of the Muslims, past and present, have been doing, so no one can trick us from this straight path, this path of al-Islam, the path of following the Quran and the Sunnah on the understanding and the practical application of the Salaf al-Saleh. Don't let the people keep lying and keep tricking us and keep making believe that this is some new statement. And I remember speaking to some of the cowards from among Ahlul Ilm, from amongst the cowards of some of the people of knowledge. When they question, what is this Da'wah to Salafiyya? We say it's the Da'wah of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam. As he said in the hadith of Sahih Muslim, they want to close their ears as if they didn't hear it. This is in the hadith of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, and on the tongues of the ulama generation after generation, as the statement of Abu Hanifa rahimahullah. And we're going to mention him as he died 150 Hijra, and to show the people that this man who they attribute the madhab to him, and he's free from that madhab rahimahullah, he said, عليكم بالأثر وطريقة السلف. I command you, I advise you to hold fast to the narrations, that which was narrated to you authentically from the reliable memorizers of this ummah, back to its messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to Jibreel, to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. I advise you to hold fast to those narrations and to the way of the Salaf. And to the way of the Salaf. How are the people going to say that they're unaware, that all we know is the madhab and the people of the madhab? Abu Hanifa, you say you know him, why don't you know this statement from him when he's advising you and commanding you to hold fast to the way of your Salaf? You say that we don't love the ulama, we love the ulama. And this is why you find the people who say we are of this Da'wah to Salafiyya, you find that their libraries are the biggest libraries of the books of the ulama, because we love the ulama rahimahullah. This is in the Arabic language and in the English language. You see our bookstore, alhamdulillah, and you see the book of the people on this Da'wah to Salafiyya. They have a nice book library in their houses and in their masjids, alhamdulillah, because this Da'wah is the Da'wah of the truth. And it's proof that we love the ulama, not just on our tongues, but that we don't believe and we don't speak and we don't worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until we see our ulama. And that our ulama take us back to the narrations of the sahab and the tabi'een and the tabi tabi'een, and they take us back to the hadith of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, and back to the book of Allah, the Quran. And this is why we love the ulama, and this is why we follow the ulama, and this is why we know from the libraries of these people walking around here on deviance that they don't have a library. Wallahi, I've seen the library of some brothers who are graduates of some university, you can put it in one box. This is his library. How does he claim that he loves the ulama? This deviant that Abu Usama made the janazah on, they don't even understand the Arabic language. How in the world are they going to call people deviant who are on this deen, loving the ulama and following the ulama. Where are your books of the ulama if you love them? Wallahi, you don't have one book of Abu Hanifa. What is the book that Abu Hanifa wrote? You don't even know the book that he wrote. Imam al-Shafi'i, you got his book? It's not even translated into English. You couldn't even read it if it was. Subhanallah al-Azim. Imam Malik, they translated his Muwatta into English. The explanation is still in Arabic. Do you have the explanation? How are you going to read the Muwatta of Imam Malik? How are you going to understand it if you claim you love the ulama? You see, the people of this Dawah to Salafiyah, we don't speak unless we're quoting the statements of the ulama, the statements of our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the statements of our Lord Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. A man writes an article, the Deviant Salafi said, I swear by Allah, I read it, it doesn't have one ayah or one hadith in it. It doesn't have one ayah or one hadith in it. This is the Dawah of deviance. How can you write against the Dawah of the Qur'an and the Sunnah and the way of ulama and you don't have no Qur'an and the Sunnah? Because this is the way of deviance. They don't have the book of Allah or the Sunnah of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam or the statements of the ulama. They claim they follow the four madhabs, as Abu Usama was mentioning. Wallahi, the statements of the ulama are proof that they are free from you and you free from the ulama of the Salaf, rahimahumullah ajma'een. Imam al-Awza'i rahimahullah, who came after him from amongst the ulama who died 156 Hijra, and we quote this narration from him often. اصبر نفسك على السنة وقف حيث وقف القوم وقل بما قالوا وكف عما كفوا عنه واسلك سبيل سلفك الصالح فإنه يسعك ما وسعهم. As he said rahimahullah, be patient. Make yourself patient with following the sunnah. This is the advice that we take from our ulama. Be patient with following the sunnah. Don't be like the deviant people who complain about the sunnah. We see the people breaking their necks to straighten the rules. It's like a military camp up there, East Orange. You should see the way they straighten the rules. Did we invent straightening the rules? Or do we learn this from the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, and we're trying to make ourselves patient with following this sunnah? We weren't raised on this sunnah, we were raised on kufr. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided us to this sunnah, and we're trying to be patient with it. Why did you leave kufr if you don't want to be patient with the sunnah? All you want to be on is that deviant that we continue to hear in that newspaper, that we're going to put a stop to it, inshallah ta'ala. That every time they come out with their foolishness, if he wants it in paper, if he wants it in spoken, if he wants a meeting, whatever that man wants, we're going to bring it to him, inshallah ta'ala. Either he's going to show us the truth, or he's going to be shown the truth. Either he's going to stand on the truth, or he's going to be known as one of the enemies of Islam, and one of the deviants amongst us, and one that the people should be aware of, and should stay away from him, and everybody that's with him, and that supports him. He's not finished yet. He said he wants to reply, and he wants to respond. We're going to wait and see if the book of Allah can come off of his tongue, or if the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam can come off of his tongue, or if the statements of the ulama can come off of his tongue. We're going to give him a chance, and either he's going to say, Alhamdulillah, the truth was made clear, we've left that foolishness, Masjid Baitul Khaliq is on the sunnah with the rest of the Muslims, and that we adhere to the da'wah to Salafiyah, the da'wah of Ahlul Hadith, of Ahlul Athar, of Al-Firqatul Najiyah, of Al-Ta'ifatul Mansura. These are the names and the characteristics of the people of the truth. Whatever name you hear them by, know that they are the people of the truth, the only people who are really on this deen. Imam Ibn Abi Zayd Al-Qirawani rahimahullah, who is known as the small Imam Malik, from Africa, rahimahullah. And those people, they claim that they were at one time following the madhab of Imam Malik. Here is the statement of one of those people in the aqidah, rahimahullah, and Ibn Abi Zayd al-Qirawani, as he says, "Al-ta'a li'a'immatul muslimin min wulati umurihim wa ulama'ihim wa tiba' salaf al-salih wa qtifa'u atharihim wal istighfaru lahum." He says in his aqidah that obedience is for the imams of the Muslims, and for the people who are in charge of the affairs of the Muslims, and for the ulama of the Muslims, and for the followers of the Salaf al-Salih, those who imitate their narrations, that which they left behind, and those who seek forgiveness for them. And we seek forgiveness for the ulama, as Abu Usama was trying to make clear, that if we ever mention a mistake of a scholar from amongst the ulama, that we seek forgiveness from him. And that we're only pointing out something in order to show the people what is correct, and never to blame our ulama, or to look down on our ulama, or to talk bad against our ulama, because it's from our aqidah that we seek forgiveness for our ulama, and that we show our love for our ulama, and that we follow our ulama in obedience to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And our love for the ulama is that we don't follow them in their mistakes, as they didn't want us to follow them in their mistakes, as we heard of some of their narrations. It's not permissible, as Abu Hanifa said, for you to follow me if you don't know where I got what I'm saying from. Meaning, if you don't know where I got this from, you can't follow me. If you don't know the Quran and the Sunnah, don't follow me in what I bring to you until I bring to you the Quran and the Sunnah. And we see this today also, as we see with the scholar Muhammad Nasiruddin al-Albani. And it's sufficient for a person's Islam to be questioned if he has anything negative to say about this scholar. No one should buy from Masjid Baitul Khaliq any book, good or bad, until they rid their bookstore of that book of deviance unveiled. And we say this about any bookstore and any masjid. If they promote this book, leave them alone. Don't buy from them. Don't speak to them. Don't say nothing to them until they leave off this deviance. They don't have the courage to say something against Islam, so they try to go to the people who are the carriers, the reliable memorizers of this deen of Islam. They try to attack them because they can't have the courage, or because they don't have the courage to stand up and say, I don't like Islam, I don't want to practice Islam. So they try to point the finger at the people who bring this deen of al-Islam. People say, blind following al-Albani. We have one of his books translated into English, this Sifatul Salatul Nabi, the Prophet's prayer described. Do you see Albani saying, do, don't do, do, don't do? Or do you see him say, the Prophet ﷺ did, 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 the Prophet ﷺ did? He referred to over 180 books, putting that one book together. And many of those books are in the makhfutat, or the manuscripts, where you can't even see them unless you travel to go read them. These people don't even have 100-something books in their library on this deen of al-Islam, and they're saying people are blind following al-Albani. What is the statement of al-Albani other than chapter facing the Qibla, or chapter putting your right hand over your left hand? And then the hadith of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, blind following is when you follow a person without him having any evidence from the Quran and the Sunnah. How are you going to blind follow a man who is always saying, call Allah, call Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? There's no such thing as blind following that man. It's called following that man, and you have been commanded to follow him. Those people who speak, as we saw in that newspaper that's finished, as we made the janazah walhamdulillah on it, all they can bring is, as he said, mawdu'at hadith. Hadith you can't even find. Ask them, where's the Arabic text for that hadith? They'll have to say, Allah knows best. You can't even promote this deen. You don't even understand where the stuff is coming from. You putting it out there as if you're ready to die on something, a falsehood, you don't even know if it's the truth. Imam An-Nawi rahimahullah, all of us know. And we mentioned many of these statements of the ulama and the talk, the brotherhood in Philadelphia. As he says, وَعْلَمْ أَنَّ الصَّوَابَ الْمُخْتَارِ مَا كَانَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَفِ رضي الله عنهم فهذا هو الحق ولا يضطرن بكثرة من يخالفه. Imam An-Nawi rahimahullah, the author of the 40 hadith, the author of Gardens of the Righteous, Riyad al-Saliheen, author of the book Al-Azkar, that the ulama say, sell your house and buy Al-Azkar, because your house won't benefit you if you don't keep your tongue wet with remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as explained by Imam al-Nawawi in his book Al-Azkar. It hasn't been translated into English, but alhamdulillah, there's been a book called Authentic Supplications of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that comes from Darul Turath al-Islami, called Darul something in English. Darul Heritage from Florida. Everybody should get their hands on that book so that they can benefit themselves and their families with keeping their tongues wet with the remembrance of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Imam An-Nawi, rahimullah, he says, I want all of you to know that that which is correct and that which is chosen, meaning chosen by the ulama as being correct, is that which the salaf were upon, may Allah be pleased with them. This is the truth. Don't be fooled by how many people oppose it. No matter how many people around America or elsewhere in the world oppose the true da'wah of Islam, the da'wah to Salafiyya, don't even be deceived. Don't even worry about how many people oppose this true da'wah of Islam. Otherwise, you'd be opposed by the people who don't believe in Islam. We're not going to worry about the people who don't follow the truth. Imam al-Shawkani, rahimahullah, from among the latter scholars, who died 1250 Hijra, he says, إِنَّهُ لَا يَنْبَغِي لِعَالِمٍ أَنْ يَدِينَ بِغَيْرِ مَا دَانَ بِهِ أَسْتَلَفُ الصَّالِحِ مِنَ الصَّحَابَةِ وَالتَّابِعِينَ وَتَابِعِيهِمْ مِنَ الْوُقُوفِ عَلَى مَا تَقْتَدِيهِ أَدِلَّ الْكِتَابُ وَالسُّنَّةِ. Imam al-Shawkani rahimullah, he says, it is not proper, it's not right or correct that a knowledgeable person worships Allah with other than that which the Salaf al-Salih used to worship Allah with. And then he went on to explain who they are. They are the Sahaba and the Tabi'een and those who follow them with holding fast to that which is proven by the Quran and the Sunnah. Just as Imam Ibn Qudama rahimahullah, he says, قَدْ ثَبَتَ وُجُوبِ اتِّبَاعِ السَّلَفِ رَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِمْ بِالْكِتَابِ وَالسُنَّةِ وَالْإِجْمَاعِ. It has been firmly established that it is compulsory to follow the Salaf, rahimahullah, or may the mercy of Allah be upon them. It has been proven by the Quran and the Sunnah and the Ijma'. This is the deen. And sometimes, astaghfirullah, we get tired of mentioning these ayat and these hadith and these statements of the ulama. But the people of deviance, they make us continue to say it. Alhamdulillah, this da'wah has reached us in America. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help it to continue to spread. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who are on this da'wah. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us the carriers and the spreaders of this da'wah. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to let us die on this da'wah with the people of this da'wah. This da'wah is the da'wah of the truth. How can somebody refute? I'm not even going to ask them to bring their proof to refute the Quran and the Sunnah and the statements of the Salaf al-Salih. How can I even ask that question? What we're asking the people to do is drop your falsehood. Drop your program. Drop your program that was invented after the program, after that which the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam brought as the deen. He is the founder and the leader of this ummah and of this da'wah, the da'wah of Islam, a da'wah to Salafiyyah, as he says in this hadith. Everybody, every da'wah that has a founder other than the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, we're calling the people to drop their da'wah today. Just like they dropped the da'wah of kufr yesterday, drop your false da'wah today and get on this da'wah of al-Islam, the da'wah to Salafiyyah, as this is the only true da'wah of al-Islam. And if you don't drop it, we're just going to feel sorry for you. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide you. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us patient and soft and compassionate and considerate. We're trying to bring this true da'wah to you. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us patient, compassionate, soft, gentle, and easy with bringing this true da'wah, a da'wah to Salafiyyah, to the people who have rejected this da'wah. This da'wah is known as the da'wah to Salafiyyah. It's also known as the da'wah of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. They say Ahl Sunnah because the Prophet ﷺ says عليكم بسنتي وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين من بعدي. I advise you, I command you to hold fast to my Sunnah. And this is why they call this Dawah Ahl Sunnah, the people of the Sunnah who have held fast to the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ and the Sunnah of the خلفاء الراشدين المهديين who came after him, and they are the Jama'ah. As the Messenger of Allah عليه الصلاة والسلام, he says عليكم بالجماعة, and the hadith of At-Tirmidhi, and both of these hadith are collected by At-Tirmidhi and they're authentic. For the Prophet ﷺ, he says, I advise you to hold fast to the Jama'ah. The Jama'ah is the truth, that which the companions of the Messenger of Allah عليه الصلاة والسلام were upon. And this is why this da'wah of Al-Islam is known as the da'wah of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, because the people, the Ahl, the adherents are to the Sunnah and to the Jama'ah, or this truth. As the Messenger of Allah عليه الصلاة والسلام had explained, تَتَفْتَرِقُ أُمَّتِي عَلَى 73 فِرْقَةً كُلُّهَا فِي النَّارِ إِلَّا وَاحِدَةً قِيلَ مَا الْوَاحِدَةَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ قَالَ الْجَمَاعَةِ. The Messenger of Allah عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said, that this Ummah will be divided into 73 sects, all of them in the hellfire except one. They said, which one is that, Ya Rasulullah? He said, the Jama'ah. And this is why the people call themselves Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. This isn't the name of a new group. This is the characteristic of the people of the truth. Just as you say, Allah is Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Al-Malik, Al-Quddus. He's Allah, Tabarak wa Ta'ala, by all of His beautiful names and His lofty characteristics. We are the adherents of Islam, the people on the Sirat al-Mustaqim, the Salafiyun, the Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. These are characteristics of the people who are on the truth, the truth of Islam, after the deviants have crept into this deen, as the Messenger of Allah عليه الصلاة والسلام explains in this hadith. They're also known as the Firqah al-Najiyah. As the Prophet ﷺ says, this Ummah will be divided into 73 sects, all of them in the hellfire except one. What is that sect? They are the Jama'ah. Or as the Messenger of Allah عليه الصلاة والسلام said in the other narration, and it's also authentic, مَا أَنَا عَلَيْهِ الْيَوْمُ وَأَصْحَابُ, that which I am upon today and my companions. This is the da'wah of the truth, the firqah al-najiyah, or the saved sect. They are called that because of this hadith of the Messenger of Allah عليه الصلاة والسلام. They are called أهل الحديث, not because they follow hadith and they don't follow Quran. The Quran is called hadith. As we mentioned the hadith of Imam Muslim in the Khutbah al-Hajjah, the most truthful speech is the hadith of Allah. فَإِنَّ أَصْدَقَ الْحَدِيثِ كِتَابُ اللَّهِ. The most truthful hadith is the book of Allah. The most truthful speech, hadith, is the book of Allah. فَبِأَيِّ حَدِيثٍ بَعْدَهُ يُؤْمِنُونَ. And what hadith will you believe in if you don't believe in this hadith, this Quran? As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refers to the Quran as hadith in many ayahs, فَلْيَأْتُوا بِحَدِيثٍ مِثْلِهِ إِنْ كَانُوا صَادِقِينَ. Bring a hadith like it if you are truthful. Bring a speech like it referring to the Quran. Under the hadith, they are the people who follow the Quran and the people who follow the hadith of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam calls what was narrated on him as hadith. As he says, مَنْ حَدَّثَ عَنِّي بِحَدِيثٍ وَهُوَ يُرَى أَنَّهُ كَذِبٌ فَهُوَ أَحْدُ الْكَاذِبَيْنِ. From the hadith of Imam Muslim and others, where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever narrates a hadith on me and he thinks that it's a lie, then he's one of the two liars. This Ahlul Hadith is a characteristic of the people of the truth. Ahlul Athar, the people who follow the Athar or the narrations, this is another characteristic of the people of the truth. As Abu Hanifa, he said, I advise you to hold to the Athar, to the narrations. Or as the Messenger of Allah عليه الصلاة والسلام answered when he was asked, who are the best of humanity? And he says, أَنَا وَالَّذِينَ مَعِي ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ عَلَى الْأَثَرِ ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ عَلَى الْأَثَرِ. From the narration of Imam Ahmad, and it's authentic, where the Prophet ﷺ answered to the question, who is the best of humanity? He said, I am, and those who are with me, and those who follow the Athar, and those who follow the Athar, those who follow the narrations, those who follow the narrations. This is a characteristic of the people of the truth, Ahlul Athar. Just like the name of Ta'ifatul Mansura, or the victorious group, From the hadith of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام from Bukhari Muslim, لا تزال طائفة من أمتي على الحق ظاهرين. And in one of the narrations, منصورين, that there will never cease to be a ta'ifa, a group from amongst my ummah on the truth, victorious. That victorious group, the ta'ifatul mansura, they are ahlul athar, they are ahlul hadith, they are the firqatul najiyah, they are the ahl sunnah wal jama'ah, they are the salafis. These are characteristics to describe the people of the truth, as this is the only true da'wah of al-Islam. We're asking, as we have already asked, all of the imams and the leaders of the Muslims in America, we're calling all of them to come to this da'wah and to put their masjid or the Islamic center or their group on the only true da'wah of Islam, the da'wah to Salafiyya. And if they want to meet with us to explain this da'wah, then the challenge has been out, the offer is out, and the people inshallah ta'ala will find us patient, compassionate, soft, gentle, and easy in trying to bring this truth to the people, as we're giving the people a chance to get upon this truth. But if the people don't want this truth, they need to shut up and be quiet and let the sunnah go forth and don't oppose it. This is what we're telling the people who don't want the truth. If you want to remain ignorant, if you want to remain deviant, if you want to remain in the 60s, after the truth of the Quran and the Sunnah and that which the Salaf of this Ummah were upon, if you want to remain on that, just be quiet in your own place and don't say nothing. And if you don't say nothing, we won't say nothing. We just be quiet and advise you. That place over there, the international community on Chancellor Avenue, we've never said anything bad about them. We were invited to their place. We spoke, inshallah ta'ala, in light of the Quran and the Sunnah. They wrote against us month after month after month. We didn't say anything about them. We came to the masjid. We tried to discuss or to recite amongst ourselves the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of His Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. We tried to correct our aqidah. We tried to purify our souls and to correct our character. We tried to learn the seerah and the hadith of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam. We tried to learn how to worship Allah on clear knowledge. We tried to get ourselves together to prepare ourselves to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to leave alone the people who are against this da'wah. But now it's come a time where if they don't be quiet, we're going to make them quiet. Or we're going to expose their foolishness to the people until the people realize that they need to be quiet. So we're calling those people to come back to this truth. And that there's no hard feelings. That there's no hard feelings. And that there's nobody bragging. Because none of us can stand up and say, I'm the man of the sunnah. I'm the man of this da'wah. I'm the author of this da'wah. I brought this da'wah. This is the da'wah of al-Islam. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent His Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam to preach to humanity. When you leave your foolishness and get on this truth, you're not submitting to me. You're not submitting to the Islamic center of these times. You're not submitting to, as they be saying, the people up the hill or the people over there. You're submitting to the da'wah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent His last prophet and messenger to. You're not humbling yourself to the people. You're humbling yourself to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. And none of us should be arrogant to go as in a bragging way to say, we are the ones who are the truth. As if it wasn't for us, the people wouldn't know the truth. If it wasn't for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sending His Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam and showering His blessings and His mercy on us, none of us would be guided. But that the shaitan would have captured us and led us astray as he led us astray in Jahiliyyah and as he's leading those people astray in Islam. We call those people and ourselves to come to the only da'wah of al-Islam, the da'wah of the truth, the da'wah to Salafiyya. And this is, inshallah ta'ala, a warning to everyone who speaks against this da'wah. We're going to mention him by his name, and we're going to refute his flimsy spiderweb argument, inshallah ta'ala, so that the people would have the choice to follow the truth. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us, قُلْ As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us at the end of Surah to Yusuf to call to this truth. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي أَدْعُو إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَى بَصِيرَةٍ أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي وَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, say, this is my path. I am calling to it on basira, on clear evidence and knowledge from the book of Allah and the sunnah of his messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, and the understanding and the practical application of the salaf. Me and those who are with me, and subhanallah, we're not from amongst the mushrikeen. Allah commands us to call to this. We don't have to think that it's wise not to tell the people to get on the truth of this da'wah to salafiyya when Allah commands us to preach this da'wah to the people. And to tell the people this is the path of Allah. The path of Allah is this da'wah to salafiyya. Following Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, the firqah al-Najiyah, the ta'ifah al-Mansura, Ahl al-Hadith, Ahl al-Athar. This is the way, and we have to call to it openly, by its name, so that people can know the truth. Can we go to the Kafirs and call them to Islam by not calling it al-Islam? By saying, do you believe in your Lord? Do you believe in the messengers he sent? Okay, you're okay. And then go and say, that's a Muslim? We have to tell them, accept Islam. As the Prophet ﷺ used to tell the people, Aslim, I command you to accept Islam. And just like we tell the people who have accepted Islam, follow the way of the righteous, of your righteous predecessors, the Salaf al-Salih, be upon this da'wah, be upon this methodology, and call the people to it. Walhamdulillah, wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad,